So good evening and welcome to this session. I want to start with a very beautiful session, introductory session, and want to welcome you all to this program, this introductory session that I have planned for our students who have gathered from across the world. And before I start, I want to quote, I built a beautiful house. You know, I read this somewhere. It was written by a small child for our school magazine. And it's so beautiful words. I built a beautiful house. It had beautiful walls, beautiful windows, but I could not get into that house because I forgot to build the doors. So this is what is important for today, that we should not forget to build our doors because that is our entry point. So many of you start very enthusiastically for any program, but they drop midway. So today we have to make a pledge that we are going to complete this program because I have promised you that I am going to cover the NCRT with the reduced syllabus that is given in 70 days. So I want to welcome, first of all, the children all across India and especially the CBSE schools which are in foreign locations from Kenya, Nigeria, Saudi. We have lots of students from Doha, Qatar, Indonesia. I'm sorry if I miss out any country, but the response has been amazing and the number of kids who want to learn is increasing. So I'm so happy that I am able to come on this platform and be able to give you this course. So the first session is going to start at 8:30, the link of which I'm going to forward to you after this session, introductory session. So today, at the onset, I want to tell you maths is everywhere. Okay, it's not, it's maths is about mindsets. Maths is about mindsets. So general perception is that maths is difficult, I cannot do it. So there are mental blocks and we have to get rid of those mental blocks. That is very important. So how to get rid of the mental blocks, how to go about this? First of all, the beginning, they say the journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. So this is your single step. You have enrolled for this program. So congratulations to you. You have started well and you are going to continue this program in the way that I'm going to forward in the WhatsApp group. So those of you who are not in the WhatsApp groups, please make it a point to be in the one. We have almost 10 groups of 250 kids each, that is 2,500 kids approximately. So if you're not in one of the groups, you can see the number that is rolling down, so you can WhatsApp me on that particular number and I'm going to add you there because all the videos are going, links are going to be posted there. So why 70 days? Because normally we used to cover this full course before January. January is the time, you know, you will have your full course examination, pre-boards they call it, before the boards, right? So the boards are going to be delayed, of course, but we have to be ready by December end with our course. So 70 days, because 30%, you know, has been reduced. 100 days is our course normally, and 30% is reduced. So we decided 70 days. So I back calculated this and said that, okay, October, December 31st, I want to finish off the course. So let me start on October 23. So that's today, and I'm sure that a lot of people were waiting for this show to happen so that, you know, you could actually attend these programs. And the reduced syllabus, if you see, it is already declared by the CBSE. The reduced course is skipping out a lot of important things, and so it becomes very easy for us to cover the course. So if you look at chapter one, the first chapter, that is the number system, real numbers we are talking about. The first exercise itself is cut, that is the Euclid's division lemma or the Euclid's division algorithm is cut. So the entire first exercise, which had a little bit of tough questions, is cancelled. And a lot of questions were asked from those questions, were asked from the first exercise, that is deleted. So we just have to start from 1.2 and we have to do 1.3, 1.4. So today at 8:30, we will be having the first class. And we are going to do 1.2. So we are going to do, the strategy is that we are going to do one exercise per day. And December 31st, the last day, we are going to finish off this. So 1.2, we are going to start 1.3 and 1.4. So Friday, Saturday, Sunday. By Sunday, your chapter one is going to be complete. And Monday, we are going to start with polynomials. And in polynomials, again, 2.1, 2.2 is there. 2.3, division algorithm, totally cancelled. Okay, that was, again, many students used to find it tough. So 2.3 is cancelled. So again, it will take 3 days. So the first two chapters is going to be a cakewalk. We are going to finish it off in 3 plus 3, 6 days, right? Now, in polynomials, there is something called optional exercise. In many of the chapters, you find this optional exercise. And, you know, there is a confusion whether we have to do this optional exercise or not. So please remember that optional exercises has to be done if you have taken standard. Okay. Although there is a footnote in the textbook that these are not from the examination point of view, please note that this is going to come for the exams. So this is important that you do the optional exercises. If you have taken basic paper, of course, you can stick to your exercises, solved examples, and so on. And besides this, now, when we go to the next chapter, that is chapter 3, that is linear equations in two variables. You have done one variable last year, two variables when you do. So linear equations in two variables, when you see what is cancelled in that is the cross multiplication method. Rest all the methods are there. Cross multiplication, again, kids used to find tough. So they have deleted that. So all the tough parts are actually deleted. Chapter 4, quadratic equation, big deletion, the word problem, the dreaded word problems is cancelled again from the third exercise. Chapter 5, when we go to arithmetic progressions, again, the third exercise, I think CBSE has done some, so the third exercise are mostly cancelled. So arithmetic progression, again, third exercise is cancelled. We have the distance formula, we have the section formula, midpoint formula as it is, the area of triangles is totally cancelled. Chapter 6, coordinate geometry, arithmetic progression, sorry, the word problems of the third exercise is cancelled. In coordinate geometry, the midpoint formula, section formula, and we have the distance formula is there, and area of triangles in coordinate geometry is cancelled. Then in triangles, chapter 7, we had four theorems, the Pythagoras theorem, the converse of Pythagoras theorem, ratio of areas of two similar triangles, and the basic proportionality theorem, which is called the Thales theorem. So the good news is that we have to do only two theorems now, that is the basic proportionality theorem or the BPT, and the second theorem is Pythagoras. So only proofs of two are required, the other two, ratio of areas, you need not do. You have to do the theorem to do the questions, of course, but the proof is not required. And similarly, converse of Pythagoras theorem is not required. Okay. So that's about triangles. Then we go to, after triangles, we have trigonometry. In trigonometry, again, the first and second exercise stays as it is. The third exercise based on complementary angles is cancelled. Okay. Again, third exercise is cancelled. And then we have applications of trigonometry. It's only one exercise, so that can be done, except for one question, which has a question on complementary angles, may not come. The rest stays intact. Then we have chapter 10, that is circles. In circles, hardly any deletion. Everything is intact. There is two exercises, very simple as compared to class 9, so you can do that. Chapter 11, constructions. The first exercise, the entire thing except for question 1 is cancelled. So 11.1, only one question, that is division of a line in a given ratio, is going to come. And the entire other questions, that is construction of similar triangles, is totally cancelled. And second exercise, there are hardly a few questions, so it will take a day or two to cover that entire construction chapter. After construction, we have the 12th chapter, that is areas related to circles. In areas related to circles, only one type of question is cancelled, that is when the central angle is 120 degrees. Okay. Otherwise, 30, 45, 60 is there in course. You need to do that. Only 120 is cancelled. Surface area and volume, the fourth exercise, that is based on frustum of cones, is cancelled. The rest, cube, cuboid, sphere, all that you did in class 9, same thing, cube, cuboid, sphere, hemisphere, cylinder, cone, it remains as it is. The fourth exercise, that is frustum of cones, is cancelled. Right. And after that, we go to the statistics. In statistics, we have mean, median, and mode. The mean, the first exercise, had three methods. The three methods were the assumed mean method, the step deviation method, and the direct method. The direct method and the assumed mean method is still in course. They have deleted the step deviation method, although it was easy and we used to do questions by that. So we have only two methods to do that, median and mode as it is. And the last exercise based on the graphs, that is the cumulative frequency curves or the ogives, that is cancelled. So then the last chapter, probability, is there intact. So we will be able to do all this very easily. But what is important is that you do one exercise a day. I will be posting the videos, taking these lectures. I will be giving you notes, but you need to go through that. As I tell that, you have to enter the room yourself. You will have to build the door. I will only help you with the videos and the notes, but you need to revise. If you are not able to understand, replay the video. That's the advantage of online classes. You can listen n number of times. You can go through the lectures in offline classes. When you listen to your teacher, you may ask the teacher to repeat once, twice. But now in an online class, you have the advantage that you have the recording, so you can play it n number of times to understand what is the concept. So if you're not able to understand, if the teacher is fast, you can pause, you can see what has happened till now, you can try to work out the question, then start playing again. So you have all those facilities when you're attending online classes. So I'm sure it's going to be a learning experience both for you and me, because the learning is always mutual. So I'm sure I'm also going to learn something from you all. You're most welcome to give your feedbacks to me through the WhatsApp groups. And I will be happy to improvise on something which you require. So at the moment, this is our target, to cover the NCRT fully, okay, from A to Z as per the reduced syllabus. You must have also seen the CBSE website, that is in the CBSE academic section. The new sample papers have been released and have been pandemic times, COVID times. We were not expecting any change in the examination pattern. We were not expecting a change. But this is really shocking that they have changed the whole pattern, and therefore all the previous sample papers that you were practicing is now redundant. You'll have to practice according to the new format. So what is the new format? It's very important, because once you finish the course, you need to practice these sample papers for your timing. And something which has been introduced newly is the case studies, which I'm going to explain to you right now. So if you look at the match paper which has been released, the sample paper, of course there is a basic paper and standard paper, but the format is same. In the basic paper and the standard paper, the first section is part A, that is section A, is objective. Now in objective means it could be one word answers, it could be fill in the blanks, it could be MCQs. Okay, so 1 mark, and how many questions are there? You will have 20 questions, but these 20 questions is giving you 32 marks. Now what is the logic there? Because the first 16 questions carry 1 mark each. Okay, that's one. Earlier we used to have 20 questions of 1 mark. Now you are having 16 questions of 1 mark, which is a fill in the blank, one word answers or one line. You will be able to solve very easily those questions if your concepts are clear. And the next step, that is question number 17, 18, 19 and 20, are your case studies. Now this is very important. This is something new. We'll have to understand how to do this. And each question will have five subparts, okay? And you have to select any four, and it's going to be MCQ. So nothing very difficult. It's going to be an MCQ, but at the same time, it's going to give you 4 marks per question. So question number 17 is 4 marks. Question number 18 is 4 marks. 19 is 4 marks. Question 20 is 4 marks. And this comes under the category of MCQ, but they are called case studies, because you are going to be given a descriptive form of question. It's like your comprehension in English. You get a comprehension and you have some questions. Same way, you are having a mathematical situation. Okay, a mathematical situation, and you know, a boy is standing on a particular at a particular coordinate, and then another friend of his is standing on another coordinate, and there'll be multiple questions like find the distance between them, or what is the midpoint between them, or you know, the distance from the origin. There'll be multiple questions based on that. So nothing to worry. It's all going to be based on the course. And you will be able to answer these questions provided you train yourself to attempt these case studies. So case studies carrying 16 marks. So 16 marks plus 16 marks. 16 marks was your 1 mark question. And now the case studies, 4 questions of 4 marks each, MCQ, is going to give you 16 plus 16, 32 marks. Right. So 32 marks is part A. So that's your objective part. And then comes your subjective part. Your 2 mark question, 3 mark questions, and a big jump, that is the 5 mark questions. Earlier we used to have only 2, 3, 4, and now from this year they have introduced the 5 mark questions. So what is the pattern now? Question number 21 to 26, Okay, question number 21 to 26. This comes in part B. Question number 21 to 26. You have six questions of 2 marks each. You are supposed to write about 2-3 lines explaining what the question is. Sufficient reason has to be given, but detailed explanations are not required, right? So you can do these 2-mark questions. So you have 6 questions of 2 marks. Then you have question number 27 to question number 33. 27 to 33, that is 7 questions for you of 3 marks. So 7 into 3 is 21 marks. So 21 marks you are getting from these 3 marks. And the last 3 questions, question number 34 to 36, is your 5-mark question. That is giving you 5 into 3, 15. Now, this is a little tricky because if you know the question, well and good. If you don't know the question, 5 marks is quite a lot. So as I'm going to discuss the course, I will also be highlighting which are your 5-mark course and which are the important questions that you'll have to make note, because this is very important that you don't miss out your 5 marks. Because earlier we used to have a 1-2-3-4 pattern, and this is the first time they're going to introduce case studies and the 5-mark questions. So it's going to be a real challenge, but there is sufficient time. You know, there is also a proposal that the board exam is going to be postponed by at least a month or two. So you can expect the exams to happen only by April or May, not before that, because the situation is pretty bad. Many of you are getting access to online, especially in the urban cities. But if you go to the rural areas and small schools, still there is a lot of problem. So, considering all these problems, the board is definitely going to get postponed. The board is definitely going to be postponed. But we need to practice at least 20 to 30 papers before the board. And for practicing papers, what is important, the course should be thorough. You should be thorough with the course. If you don't know the course, there is no point attending a sample paper. Okay. And always, I would say your NCERT is your Bible. I'm not only talking about your maths. I'm talking about maths, science, SST, English, whatever. Your NCERT is like your holy book. Just go through all these concepts word by word, and you are going to get a very good percentage. Of course, then the students who are doing the standard paper need to do exemplar and go through the questions which have come in the past 10 years. And most importantly, go through the new sample papers which are released. And I'm sure in the coming days, more and more sample papers are going to be released so that you are able to practice more and more. So the first target for us as of now is to finish the course by December 31st. And then you have January, February, March, April. You have about 3-4 months to practice enough and more sample papers. The more you practice, the better it is. In maths, nobody can say that I am perfect. I have finished my syllabus, so I can relax. The more you practice, there will be something more to do. So do a variety of questions, but please make sure that you don't skip NCERT, because this is going to be the major chunk of questions that are going to be coming in the boards, especially during this year, because it's pandemic. I'm sure the board is going to understand that what the children are going through. So it's going to be relatively, I would say, a paper which should be 80 to 90% directly from NCERT. So best wishes, my best wishes to you. And I hope that I can guide you in these 70 days to your destination of completing the course. So I look forward to your participation and your active participation, because, you know, many of you join and then what happens, they don't even bother to watch the videos. So it becomes a little problematic, because I remember, if you're occupying one seat in the WhatsApp group, you are denying the opportunity to another person, because you know that all our groups are now almost full, and we stopped our registration today morning. So if you are not actually interested, you should not be in the groups, because you are blocking another man's seat, and the resources that I am, you know, sending in those WhatsApp groups will be meaningless to you. Then it's better that you quit the groups and make space for the others who wish to join. So thank you so much for sparing your time today. I know you are from different parts of the world, so somewhere it's early morning, some late night. But I took up this time so that it is more or less convenient to everyone in different parts of the world. So that's it. So that's it from my side. So as I said, today I'm going to be releasing the first class at 8:30 in the respective WhatsApp groups. And if you're not in any of the WhatsApp groups, group number 1 to 10, please, you need to WhatsApp me on the number that is displayed down, 9818946850. And I'll be adding you to the groups, and you will be able to get access to all my lessons, video lessons, and also the notes. So best wishes to everyone. Hope you have a good time. I also want to sincerely thank all the educators, teachers who have collaborated with me in preparing content, in motivating their students to join this program. So big thank you from my side. So good night, all of you. And I'm sure you will enjoy this course as much as I will enjoy in delivering the lectures. So good night, take care, and be ready for the session at 8:30. Thank you so much.